Alright guys, so this is actually just a quick intermediary update. And for those of you who do not know, I actually released an MCP server for Unreal Engine just last week. I was actually pleasantly surprised to see that there was quite a lot of interest in what I was doing. So what I decided to do is to record a very quick video showing some of the capabilities of what it can do. My plan was to actually record a much longer video going from what we see here, which is a blank project, and then getting a full game just using text prompts. But I still need a bit of time to get to that stage, and I didn't want to go too long without having an update, so I decided to record this video. There'll probably be bugs, and I'm still fixing things on the fly, but hopefully this provides a little bit of a lens into the process. So just to show you here, on the left-hand side, you can see that there's a bunch of tools that expose into the Unreal MCP server. All right, so let's try this, right? So we say, create a blueprint for a cube, and then add it to the wall. All right, so what this is going to do is that it's going to determine what kind of tools to call from the left and then translate it to within Unreal Engine. So it says it's going to create something called BP Cube. And if you go to the content browser here, you can see it actually has created BP Cube. But because it's a blueprint, it actually, if I open this up right now, that it doesn't actually have any visualization, right? It's just an empty blueprint. And what it's going to do now, as you can see here, is that I'm going to add a component called a static mesh component and call it a cube mesh, because that's what is needed to actually make it look like a cube. Like I said, if you're familiar with Unreal, this will be quite familiar to you. If you're not familiar with Unreal, this is actually a good way to learn how Unreal actually thinks about things. So it's actually added, and you can see now your blueprint has a mesh, and then it set the mesh to a static cube. And now it's actually going to compile it. So as you can see here, there's this top left-hand corner here is the compile, and it can actually compile it for you. And if it compiles with no errors, like it says here, successful, it's going to spawn it within the world. So I'm going to run it now, and you can see it's going to spawn the blueprint actor. And usually I will have to take a look at this, and it spawned it, and it says it spawned, and you can take a look. Here it is. It is here, BP cube 1. So it's managed to do that. All right, so what we're going to try to do now is something slightly different. So I'm going to say, let's make the letters A and I next to each other using cubes. Use quite a few cubes so that it is legible. First, show me how you would do it in ASCII. Then if it looks good, we'll put it in game. So let's see what he comes up with here. And okay, so it's going to do it something like this. Okay, so about 7 units tall, made of diagonal sides and horizontal bars. Ace, letter I, simple white column, same height. Perfect. All right, so he wants to do it this way. Okay, so how many cubes do you need? This is just to give it a little bit more idea of the spatial requirements. So it says top row of A is 3 cubes. And then it's going to do second row. Perfect. Please keep in mind Unreal in terms of coordinate system and units so that the cubes and eventual letters are properly spaced out. All right. And like I said, you can do a lot more things with this MCP server, input and controls. I actually did a quick Flappy Bird clone in my original video, and I'm planning to build a full tutorial series of how you can use the MCP server to build a full game. And I'm still working on that. I still have a couple more tools to make, but I just want to do this one just so you can see how this whole thing works. Okay, so it's using this coordinate system. I said, let's begin spawning the actors. And I'm going to say, I'm actually going to delete this cube for now, because it might want to use a smaller cube. Okay, let's begin by creating a blueprint cube of decent size, and then we shall spawn multiple instances of it. All right, it's quite verbose, and I'm spending a lot of time like making sure that it has enough context, but I think you can actually get quite far by just letting it do its thing. All right, so first thing it's going to do is going to do create blueprint letter cube. Okay, so we go. It's going to create it there. And then it's going to add a static mesh component. So it's going to actually give it a cube look. And you will see over here, it will change this. It will change to a cube quite shortly. There you go. It's changed to a cube now. And then it's going to compile it so that we can actually start spawning it within the world. And let's make sure, let's take a look. Let's see if it's going to be able to create the letters for me. Okay, so it's going to do spawn blueprint. And I can see it's starting to spawn, right? There's one dead. Oh, there we go. And then it's going to do It's going to focus the viewport. My focus viewport, okay, there you go. So you can see it automatically focused the viewport to make sure that it looks great. So that's great, but I actually don't really care about that. It looks good to me. Let's build the rest of the letter A. All right, so let's see how we can go around. So it's going to do bottom and work up using our coordinate system. So it says Y is left, right, and Y is up, down, and cool. And he actually deleted the actor that I had over there because he needs to actually think about how to do this. Okay, cool. So he's going to do the first one. He's actually created a little script for itself to know how to do the letter. And there we go. Okay, so that's the first part. I actually can turn on YOLO mode where you'll just automatically just run these in sequence without me having to click yes all the time. And let's actually hide the landscape for a while so we can actually see how this is actually being created. So remember, our ASCII art kind of looks, and can I get to the top? Kind of lost context, but it's fine. Let's just keep pressing run tool, and there we go. All right, you can see, oh, there we go. Yep. And it's going to do, yep. So it's going to do 9 cubes. Cool. There we go. Okay, so it's doing crossbar and middle bar 9 cubes, it says. And sometimes, because of the rate that it spawns the cubes, sometimes you can't forget. All right, so that doesn't look very much like the letter A, does it? Let's see. Maybe it end up looking like a letter A. Who knows? AI knows better than I do. Okay, I can see the letter A showing up now. Cool. I guess this bar across, probably could have just used 1 cube for the bar, but okay, that's fine. I'm not an artist. I'm sure AI knows art better than I do, and this was just done very scrappily. So we have a letter A here. Yep. Okay, so now it's going to do the top row. There's still one more row. I guess it really wants to have a very high fidelity. There you go. Perfect. All right. Nice. Cool. So it's done A. All right. So it's going to focus the viewport. Let's see if it can actually do that. Sometimes it gets a bit buggy with how it focuses. Okay. Yeah, that's pretty good, right? It actually automatically focused the viewport for the letter A. So let's do letter I, but instead of multiple cubes, just use one and scale it. I'm just showing you a different way of doing this. So it's a straight column. We can just use a single cube and match the height. So it's going to spawn one of the cubes here. Okay, there you go. So it's going to do it here and stretch it. Same center, it's going to scale. Okay, good. I think it didn't realize that you needed to scale it. All right, so that's a bug there, which I need to fix. I was going to try to focus the viewport once again. And there you go. Okay, cool. The letter I's cube is not scaled. Please scale it. All right, so let's see if that works. I've been changing and refactoring a little bit of how you change properties of blueprints. And it says invalid type for parameter scale in set actor transform. So let's spawn in a new, it's going to try to delete it and create a new one with the right scale. So there's definitely a bug here in how the scale was actually sent. And in fact, I'm actually pretty sure that there must be a way to, so I'm going to do a live debugging session here. Invalid parameter for scale in two sector transform.
Cool.
Yeah. Okay. So where can we go? I would say it's probably in the editor tool. So in editor tools, let's set actor transform and yeah, so it's actually here, right? It's a list of invalid type parameter scale. So I suspect that this is the annoying thing with cursor at the moment and Python MCP servers is that you can't actually do stuff like this, right? You just have to say, you actually, easiest way to do it is actually to just do this. And I think this will work. So I'm going to reset the, I'm going to actually just get the MCP server to refresh. And let's try setting the scale again using set at the transform. All right, let's take a look and see if that works. Because I think that's probably the reason why. Yeah, it's a bit annoying and I can't wait for them to fix it because without the type hints, this technically doesn't make sense, right? It should be list, float, and if you don't supply it, it should be an empty. It does make sense, it's just that it's not good practice. And losing the type hints isn't great. So let's try it this time. All right, so it's going to set it. All right. Success. Okay, cool. And there you go, right? There you have it. You actually set the transform to what it should have been. So discover the bug, fix the bug, all live in front. So anyway, this is just a quick overview of how the MCP server works. Like I said, there's a lot more stuff you can do. And check out the post that I made on Twitter if you want to see it creating a Flappy Bird clone. And what I'm going to do is, like I said, this video is more of a stopgap, trying to give an update on where we are. There's going to be a new update that has a lot more tools and fixes a lot of bugs, including this one. And I'll be doing a full video on how you can build an entire game using pretty much just prompts in cursor. I'll probably do it for Claude Desktop as well, but hopefully it'll be useful and exciting. And so yeah, stay tuned for a lot more. All right, see ya.